So people often ask us, what is a heat pump? How does it work? It's actually quite simple, basic technology that we all live with. It's exactly the same as a domestic fridge or freezer. The inside of a fridge is cold and the back plate of it is hot because it's taken the heat out of the fridge and pushed it out the back. What we're doing with a heat pump is kind of reversing that. So the heat pump takes in air at the back, pushes it out the front. The air, when it comes out of the front of this, is very cold because it's taken all the heat out of it. The heat that it's taken out is then put onto a refrigerant circuit. So the heat from this then goes onto that refrigerant and it boils it off. So refrigerant becomes a gas at a very low temperature. So a small amount of temperature input, you boil off the liquid into a high volume gas. A bit like when you put your finger on a bike pump and pump it, it gets hot. That compression that gives it the high grade heat that turns that 1, 2, 3 degrees of heat into sort of 40, 50, 60 degrees of heat, whatever it is that you need on the inside. It's really basic, simple stuff. I think it's been in use since like the 30s, something like that. We never really needed it in England because we just had cheap coal, cheap gas, cheap oil. Obviously we don't have that anymore, so now we're having to look to more advanced technologies such as heat pumps. So we're just outside looking at the external units of a heat pump. On the inside you get to these, so you've got two pipes coming in from the external. They either fill your hot water tank with hot water, so baths and showers and sinks and whatnot, or else they go the other way and they heat your space heating, so be it underfloor or radiators. You're not heating your house with that 1 degree of heat you've got from outside, that's just the catalyst to get the whole thing going. So that 1 degree, whatever, boils off the refrigerant, compression, turns it into high grade heat, which is what then heats these. So hot water, easily heat pumps can get them up to 55, 60 degrees. We generally recommend to store it at about 50 or 55 because that's a better efficiency. The lower you can get the temperatures, the higher your efficiency will always be. Space heating, so be it, you know, underfloor radiators, whatever it may be. Ideally, you're looking for a flow temperature between 35 to 45 degrees if possible. The maximum we would ever design a system to is 55 degrees. Once you go above that, heat pumps actually become quite inefficient. So heat pumps are very good at maintaining low flow temperature. That means you will need larger radiators than you would for a traditional system or tighter spacing on underfloor heating. How much bigger, it's impossible to say without asking you a bunch of questions, but we're more than happy to do that. So pick up the phone and drop us an email and we'll see what we can do. How does it work? It's quite simple. There's a bunch of pixies in here and they run around a treadmill, and the faster they run, the hotter the water gets, and then that heats your home. Job done, really.
See you later.